Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Success Engineering. Today we are going to see how to use HAP software, hourly analysis program software, in actual practice for heating and cooling load calculation. So before I start this video, I would like to request you to please like my video, like and comment my video, and don't forget to share and subscribe my channel. So let's start now. So first of all, you should know the parameter required to do the calculation of heating and cooling load in actual practice. So and as per Dubai standard, in the Middle East, and as per actual practice, we are using HAP software for cooling and heating load calculation in the Middle East. Most of the places and most of the company, they are using the HAP software. So let's start now. First of all, this is the HAP software. To start this, just click on this. So this software is provided by actually Carrier, and this software name is Hourly Analysis Program. I am using a version 4.9, and this is from North American edition. Just cancel this. Also cancel this. So this software looks like this. This is the window of this HAP software. So here you can see there is untitled given. So just right click here and go to the property. And write here project name. So you can see here this project is OMB building, cooling and heating load calculation for OMB building. First of all, you should know the parameter required for heating and cooling load calculation. So we need building drawing as well as U value. You can see here in the actual practice in the Dubai, this is the U value. This is generally given by civil people. So I have this U value from the civil people, and we use in the actual practice this one. I have used this for most of the projects in Dubai. So you can see here, this is OMB building and external wall section. So this is the layer number, and this is the thickness of each layer. You can see here, this the first layer is 1 inch outside surface resistance. Thickness is 1 inch, number of layer is 1. Second layer is 0.5 inch plaster cement sand. Here is the thickness 0.5 inch, and third is 8 inch concrete block. So each layer density and R value is given here. After that, the mass is also given for each layer, and at the end of this, you can see this here. The final U value, you can find it. The U value of all is 0.089 BTU per hour degree Fahrenheit per square feet per hour. The second is roof. Also, the layer of roof is given here, and you can see here the U value of overall U value of this roof is 0.087 BTU per hour degree Fahrenheit square feet. And third one is floor. You can see this floor, the layer of floor is also given here, and total overall U value is 0.375 BTU per hour degree Fahrenheit per square. And fourth one is partition. U value of partition, also the layer of partition is given here, and the overall U value is 0.401. So to calculate the cooling and heating load calculation of this building, we need the U value and this drawing. Okay, also there's door and window schedule. So I have opened already this HAP software. Just write here project name. OMB building. project number is 001001, and date is today date, and contact person name. So designer, designer, you can write here any name. Just select the contact type is designer. Project manager, and write the project manager name and simply click OK. Start once again this app software. You can see here this is starting now. Simply click here new. Okay, then you can set here, you can see here the project and general. This pop-up box is open. So project and general, go to the project and set here ventilation extender. You can see here as standard 62.1 2007. If you can click on this drop down button, you can see there are a number of standard ventilation extender given here. So I am selecting here as standard 62.1 2010, and this energy extender is 2010 as standard 90.1 2010, and this rating system LED is 2009. You can put your currency AED. Click OK. Okay, then you go to this untitled, just simply right click and go to the property, provide the project name OMB building, number is 001, SEC, and the designer. Click OK. Okay, now we should go to this first option is weather property, so we should provide the weather parameter. So click in this weather property, you can see here this first type design parameter, and second type is design temperature, design solar and simulation. So go to this first type design parameter, and you can select the region where you are going to design this project. You can select here Middle East, and the location of Middle East is UAE, and the city is Dubai. After selecting these three parameters, you can see here all remaining parameters automatic software is cast. You can see your latitude is 25.3 degree, longitude -555.3, and elevation is 16 feet. Summer dry bulb is 107 degree Fahrenheit, summer coincide wet bulb 75, daily range 17.5, winter dry bulb, winter coincide wet bulb, and remaining parameter should be the same. So simply select this three parameter, click OK. Now go to this schedule, so create the schedule. Simply click on this tree view and then click on this list view, double click. You can see here three tabs is given here in this dialog box. So you can see here the first, go to this schedule type and provide here schedule name. So providing the people, and schedule type is fractional. You can see here the people, lighting, equipment, miscellaneous, latent, ventilation, so many schedule type given here. So select and this people is comes under this fractional schedule. Simply click and then go to this second tab, hourly profile. So you can select this first profile. If you want to change, you can change also here. You can see you can increase and decrease your profile as per the schedule, but we are considering most of the time is maximum 100%. See, you can increase and decrease as per your requirement. So but we are selecting the 100%. So I'm selecting this profile 1, then go to this assignment tab and select this from January to December, from Sunday, Monday to Sunday, including holiday. Select on 1, file 1, simply click OK. Now you can see that I have created this people schedule. So simply right click on this, duplicate. You can see here, just type another schedule name. I'm creating lighting schedule, PANG lighting. This also comes under fractional. Go to this hourly profile, simply click on first profile, assignment, then select all, click OK. Now third schedule is, again simply select this schedule and click right click, duplicate, then equipment. What the schedule name, equipment, it also comes under fractional. Then go to this hourly profile, simply click on first profile, then go to the assignment, simply select all, click on first profile, then simply click OK. Now fourth schedule is thermostat, so duplicate again, type here TS. Thermostat comes under fan thermostat, so simply click on fan thermostat, then go to the hourly profile, simply click first profile. Then assignment, select all, select, and then again click first, then OK. You can see here I have created this schedule. Now go to this wall, double click on the list view. Then you have to set here U value as per this table. You know, this is the external wall. So simply click here medium weight wall. Rename this external wall. Okay, external wall, and this observability is 0.9, and color is outside color is always selecting the dark, because the dark color observe more heat. Okay, then you have to select the layer. So number of layer is here. You can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 layer is there. So simply set this 5 layer. First layer is, one is outside surface resistance. So outside, you can see here, this is the last layer is outside surface resistance. The thickness just simply provide here 1 inch. This second layer, 0.5 inch plaster cement. So here you can simply rename to 0.5 inch plaster cement. Okay, and you can provide this thickness 0.5. And then density is, you can see here, the density is 116.25 pounds per cubic feet. So 116.25, and then go to this specific heat. Specific heat you should keep as it is. Okay, if you don't know, you keep as it is. Then you go to this R value. You can see here R value is 0.1. simply provide here 0.100, and then go to the second layer. Second layer is 8-inch concrete block. So 8-inch, you can click on this drop down button, you can find here 8-inch common 8-inch hollow concrete block. So simply 8-inch concrete block, and thickness is 8, density is, you can find here density is 84.375, and then R value is, you can see a 10.128. R value is 10.128. Now go to this third layer. You can see here 0.5-inch plaster cement. Again 0.5-inch plaster cement. Simply copy this and paste here. 0.5-inch plaster cement. Again here 0.5, density you don't know, sorry, density is 116. Simply copy this and paste it here, and again copy this R value, paste here. Okay, now go to this fourth layer. 1-inch inside vertical surface resistance, 1-inch outside, 1-inch inside and 1-inch outside. So you simply delete this layer, remove. Now you can see here the overall U value I am finding here 0.088. you can see here 0.089, it is minor difference, so it's okay. Simply click OK. I have created the wall U value. So simply click OK. Now the roof U value is, simply go to the roof and double click on this list view. Simply select your lightweight roof and rename it to this roof. Outside surface color is dark. Then go to this layer property, select the layer sandstone. This layer is sandstone, so rename it sandstone. The density is 125 and thickness is 2 inch. Simply provide your thickness. Density is 125. Then R value is, you can see here 0.231. You can see your density also given here, pounds per square feet. Density pounds per cubic feet. Sorry, this weight pounds per square feet is here. So go to this second layer. 0.5-inch plaster cement. So simply here 0.5-inch plaster. Type here 0.5, density, capacity is a specific heat, is density is 116.25. so density is here, provide the density 116. 0.25. Then R value is 0.2. This R value is 0.2. Go to this third layer, extruded polyester insulation board 2 inch, insulation board 2 inch, density is 2 inch also. R value, you can see R value is 9.5, so 9.5. Go to this next layer, lightweight concrete is 2 inch, lightweight concrete 2 inch, density is 100 pounds per cubic feet. Here 100, and R value is 0.344, so 0.344. go to this next layer, can see next layer is reinforced concrete is 8 inch, reinforced concrete 8 inch, specific, then density is 150. R value 0.624. Then go to the next layer, one 5 inch plaster. Type your 0.5 inch plaster, 0.5 inch plaster, 0.5, then density is 116. You can see a 0.5 inch plaster, 116 and 0.2. R value is 0.2. Now you can see this overall U value is 0.083 and here is 0.087. If you want to adjust, simply increase the R value. U is equal to 1 by R actually. So if you increase the R value, then U value will decrease. But if you decrease this R values, and then U value will be increased. So simply decrease here, make it 8. You can see 0.94, and I need 0.087. So 8.5. You can make 9. You can see 0.086. Here is 0.087, so it's okay. Simply click okay. Okay, now create the door and window schedule. So simply click on this list view, tray view, and double click on list view. You can find here the door pop-up box. You can see, you can find in this drawing the outside door, the external door. The external door is D1 only, and the size is 4 feet by 7 feet. So simply click here D1 and provide the gross area. in square feet. So you can see here 4 by 7. 4 into 7. So you can find 28 square feet. Simply enter the value 28 square feet and U value of door is 0.3. It is default. Simply click OK. If you have the U value from the supplier or from the civil worker, you write it here. You can type. Okay, you can type here. Otherwise, simply leave as it is. This is from the software by default, so it's okay. Now window schedule, double click. Single click on list view, tray view, and double click on list view. And simply provide the window detail, window name, so W1. You can see here W1 window is 6 feet by 4 feet. So provide 6 feet by 4 feet, so width is 4 feet. The height is 6 feet and this U value will be given by supplier, door supplier, so simply type it here if you have, otherwise it will take default, so simply click OK. Now go to the, now we need to create the space, so go to the space, simply click on this space, the tree view, and double click on list view. Provide the space name. So this is the living room. First of all, I am trying to calculate this for the living room. So simply provide the name living room. Living room one. The floor area, you can see here 20 feet by 18 feet, so floor area is 20 feet by 18 feet, so floor area is 360 square feet, so 360, and average ceiling height is 13 feet. You can see here ceiling height is 13 feet and building weight is medium weight, 80 pounds per square feet, and the building type is for outdoor ventilation requirement. Space type you can select from this drop down button. So go to this living room, just look for this living room here in this list. You can see a bedroom or living room, simply select this, and after selecting you can find here this outdoor air requirement 1, this 5 cfm per person, and 2 is 0.06 cfm per square feet. This is taken from ASRA 62.1 2010. Okay, now go to this second tab, internals. So simply select this overhead lighting type, picture type is receipt vented. What is generally we are considering as per the thumb rule 1.4 watt per square feet, ballast multiplier is 1, and just select the schedule, lighting schedule, from this drop down button you have created already, so select the lighting. Now you can see here there is task lighting also. So in this project, this task lighting is not applicable. Leave as it is. Then electrical equipment. Electrical equipment is also, actually this is taken the heat dissipation for actual equipment, from actual equipment. This is already, and this has been also given by supplier. For example, in this room we have one computer or one television, so what is the heat dissipation from that equipment? you have to provide here, otherwise 1.4 watt per square feet. Okay, and simply select this schedule equipment and occupancy is 2 people, so generally for the bedroom we are considering 2, and activity level is seated at least medium walk. You can see here the sensible heat is 295 and latent heat is 455. Simply select this people schedule, and this miscellaneous load is generally considered for the kitchen equipment like oven, washing machine, etc. Now go to this third tab, wall, window and door. Just select this exposure wall. Okay, you can see here for these rooms the exposed wall is north and west. So first select this north and west. From this exposure select north, and then second one is west. Now simply provide this wall gross area. So north wall is 18 feet by 13 feet. You simply calculate the area, 18 feet by 13 feet, 234. So 234 wall gross area, and window quantity is 1. Simply select this window schedule from here and select also wall, external wall, and there is no door, so it should be 0. Now go to this west exposure. You can see here the length of this west side wall is 20 feet and the height of the building is 13 feet. So calculate this gross area, 20 by 13, 260 square feet. So 260, this window type is 1, window quantity is 1, select this window 1, then window 2 is none. Here also you can select window 2 is none, and door quantity is 0 because there is no door, no exposed door in this room, so it should be 0. Select this external wall also. Now go to this fourth tab, roof and skylight. So in this room, the roof area will be the same as per the floor area, and there is no skylight. So simply exposure we are considering always most of the time is horizontal roof, and the roof gross area is 360. So you can see here this floor area is 360, roof area is also 360 square feet, and there is no skylight, so it will be 0. And simply select this roof schedule, so roof, and then go to this next tab, infiltration. Design cooling is actually we consider 5%, and ACH is 5 also. And then go to this next tab, floor. You can see here the floor type is given there, given here 4 conditions. So first one is floor above condition space. This means your floor is above condition space, that means the below floor is condition space. Second one, if you click on this second condition, so floor above unconditioned space, that means your floor is, your design floor is above unconditioned space, that means your below floor is unconditioned, there is no AC. So you should provide this all information, floor area for this floor above unconditioned space, that means the floor area, total U value, unconditioned maximum, temperature minimum. And then third condition is slab floor on grade. Ungrade is nothing but your design floor is directly on the ground, so it is ground floor only. And fourth is slab floor below grade is nothing but this underground. Suppose your design floor is underground below this floor level, so it's called slab floor below grade. So in my condition, this third one is applicable, slab floor on grade. Then you should provide this floor area, so 360, and the floor U value you can see here. The U value of floor is 0.375. So simply provide here 0.375, 0.375. There is no exposed perimeter. Let's go to this next partition. You can find the partition, ceiling partition or wall partition. Go to this drawing, you can see here adjacent room is toilet, so this is unconditioned space and this is conditioned space. So this will be your partition wall. Partition wall is nothing but the wall between conditioned and unconditioned space. Okay, so simply calculate the area, cross area of this wall. You can see here the length of the wall is 12 feet and height is 13 feet. So simply click here 12 feet by 13 feet, 156 wall partition. Provide the area 156, then wall U value. Partition U value, sorry, for partition U value is 0.401. Then unconditioned space maximum temperature, the ambient space maximum. So first of all, you have to provide this ambient space, ambient maximum temperature. So ambient temperature is 107. You can see in the weather property, you have the dry bulb temperature is 107. Then unconditioned space maximum temperature will be less than 5 degree from this ambient. So it will be 102 degree Fahrenheit. And then third one is unconditioned space minimum temperature. So ambient space minimum is formula. The range is equal to unconditioned space maximum minus unconditioned space minimum. So unconditioned space maximum temperature is 102. And daily range you can found here. If you go to this climatic data, simply select here United Arab Emirates, then all region Dubai. You can see here the mean daily range is 17 degree. So unconditioned space maximum temperature 102 minus unconditioned space minimum temperature. So daily range is equal to unconditioned space maximum minus unconditioned space minimum. So you know this unconditioned space maximum 102 minus 17 daily range. So unconditioned space maximum temperature will be 85. It will be 85, and this will be at 5 degree more. Ambient space minimum temperature will be 5 degree more than this. It will be 90. Okay, you simply click OK. So you have created the one space. Now for other space, For example, this living room 2, simply right click on this space and duplicate it. Simply rename this room living room 2, then area will be 20 by 12 floor area. So 12 by 20, 240 square feet. So 240, average ceiling height will be 13, building weight same, and this will be the same ventilation requirement. Then go to this internal, this will be the same, everything will be same. Then go to this wall and roof, just change this exposure wall. So from this drawing, the exposure will be north and east. So simply select north and east. So north side wall cross area will be 20 by 13. So simply multiply 20 by 13 feet. So 260. Here 260, and quantity of window is 1, and the window schedule W1, and window 2 will be 0, and door quantity will be 0. East side 12 by 13, so 12 feet by 13 feet, 156 window 1. You can see here there is one window. Then go to the roof and skylight. Simply provide this 240 roof area. So 240, select this roof exposure, then infiltration will be same, floor area will be slab floor on grade, then 240 everything will be same, then partition will be same also here. There is wall partition and it will be 156 square feet. Simply click OK. Now calculate for this dining room. So simply duplicate this and provide this dining room rename, and floor area will be, you can see 27 by 17. So floor area will be 27 feet by 17 feet, 459 square feet. And the height of the average ceiling height will be 13, and outdoor ventilation requirement you select from this drop down list dining. Then found here dining. You can look for the dining area. Cafeteria, fast food, dining room. Now go to this internal, this will be same, and the number of people taken from the furniture layout, you can just simply count this number of table. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, so total people will be 8. They are seated at rest. Then go to this exposure, you can see here the east and south exposure is there. Please select from here east and then south. Simply provide this wall gross area for the east exposure. 17 by 13, 221, 221. Window quantity is, there is no window, so it should be 0, and also here none. Then south side 27 by 13. So 351, 351. Window is 1 and door is also 1. Simply select window and door D1. Then go to the roof and skylight. So 459 floor area. So simply provide here 459. Infiltration will be same, floor slab, floor on grade, 459 floor area. Then partition, you can see here, is there any partition or no. So there will be a partition here, 6 by 12. So 6 by 13, sorry, 13. So gross area of the wall is 78. Simply provide here 78 square feet. Simply click OK. Now this next space is kitchen. So kitchen also we providing cooling as well as ventilation. So simply right click and duplicate. So rename this kitchen. Kitchen area is 18 by 9. So simply here 18 by 9. 162. Height is 13 feet and it will be here. You can found the kitchen or break room. So kitchen is here, kitchen, and go to this internal. Number of people you have type here 2 and medium walk. Then go to this wall and window, found the exposure, so south and west, south and west exposure is there, west and south. So west exposure wall gross area 9 by 13 9 13 by 9 117 117. And there is no window, so everything will be zero here, none. And the south exposure wall cross area is 18 by 13. So 18 by 13, 234, and window is 1. Window 1. Select here and this will be none. Okay, then go to this roof and skylight. So 162. So just simply provide here 162 roof gross area, and floor is slab floor on grade 162. Partition, you can see here there is no partition, so it will be zero. Simply OK. Make it 0 and OK. Now you can see here I have created all the space. And this actually, this in the actual practice for any project, we are calculating the same same the cooling and heating load calculation in the HAP software hourly analysis program. And most of the time this HAP software is using in the actual practice in the Middle East. So you can see I have the created all the space. Now go to the system. We need to create the system. Go to the system in the tree view and simply double click on the list view. And you can see here there are 5 tabs given here in the system. So select this general tab and simply provide this air system name. So I am providing here package AC, okay, and the equipment type is package rooftop unit. Air system type is CAV system, CAV single zone. So constant air volume single zone, number of zone is 1, And now go to the second type, system component. So ventilation here is constant and outsource 62 point. Ventilation sizing method is 62.1. In go to the, this, simply click on demodification is 50%. Then cooling is supply temperature is 56 degree Fahrenheit. Coil bypass factor is 0.12. This actually coil bypass factor is given by supplier, manufacturer of the machine. And the remaining parameter will be same. And just uncheck the central heating because we not required this heating, just we are doing the cooling load. Then go to the supply fan, select this fan type forward curve, and there are so many options given here. You can select as per your requirement. So I'm selecting the forward curve main, and configuration is draw through. Total static is nothing but the heat generated by the fan inside the machine. So generally it will consider at safe side 3 inches of water gauge. Then remaining parameter will be same. Then go to this duct system. You can see here duct system data. Supply duct data, duct heat gain is considering 5% and heat leakage is also 5%. And this return duct or duct plenum data, return here via ducted data. Then go to this zone and you can see here there are four options: space, thermostat, supply terminal. So I'm selecting this space, and now you should add all this space to the zone. Okay, simply click add. You add all these spaces in the zone. You can see here there is only one zone, and then go to this thermostat. Simply set this thermostat setting here. The cooling thermostat set point occupied is 75 is the comfort temperature only. Unoccupied is leave as it is, and heating thermostat you can leave as it is because we are not bothered about heating thermostat setting. And this TS, the thermostat throttling range, is nothing but the difference between occupied cooling thermostat and minus heating thermostat set point. So 75 minus 70, it will be 5. Diversity is 100%, and direct exhaust air flow is nothing. Simply select this thermostat schedule, so TS, then go to supply terminal. Minimum air flow 5, so 20 cfm per person. And then go to this sizing data. After zone, go to this sizing data tab and just select system sizing, and you can provide your safety factor. Cooling sensible is 10% and cooling latent is 5%. And this option is hydronic sizing specification, chilled water delta T and hot water delta T. That means this chilled water return, chilled water supply and chilled water return temperature. It will be applicable only in the chilled water system. So we are designing for DX system. So leave as it is. It is not applicable in our project. Then simply go to zone sizing, it will be the same, and then sizing data is computer generated. You can also provide here, if you select this user defined, you should provide the zone, supplier, CFM zone, everything you should remember. Simply collects computer, select computer generated, then okay. You can see I have created this system. Now you should know, you want to see the report. So how to report, how to generate the report? Simply select the system, and you can see here view design report. Simply click. Now you can see at the report option and selection, you should select whatever report you require. So system sizing summary, simply check. Zone sizing, simply check. Then ventilation sizing summary also, if you need, you simply select. Otherwise unselect. System load summary, then zone load summary, I am selecting this. Then zone load summary also I am selecting. The space load is summary also selecting. Then hourly system, yes, system load is not required. Then psychrometric, system psychometric also required. Just simply click on preview. It will take little bit time to generate the report. See, this report is generated. If you can see here, this here system sizing summary for package AC. See here, project name is OMB building. I am prepared by Success Engineering Consultant. Time and date is here. Simply save this. Systems design report. Imperial system. Simply select desktop and save. Now you have to review this report. See here the air system name. Air system name is package AC, and the equipment class is package rooftop. Air system type single zone CAV system, and number of zone is 1. Floor area is 1221 square feet, and location is Dubai, United Arab Emirates. Now this sizing calculation is for the month, the calculation month January to December, and sizing data is calculated. And coil load is total coil load 4.5 ton. Okay. MBH, and this coil load is given in the MBH. So 1 MBH is nothing but 1000 BTU per hour. So simply convert this 54.3 into 1000. So this value will be in BTU. So simply divided by 12,000, because 1 ton is nothing but 12,000 BTU per hour. So simply divide with 12,000, so you can get the value in tonnage. You can see here 4.5 ton. It will be the same. And the airflow is, so sensible coil load is 48.8. Coil CFM at June 15. June 15 is nothing but this the month of June. Peak load is June 3 o'clock, 2125 CFM. Outdoor ventilation air data is, this outdoor air requirement is 261 CFM. Now the second page is zone sizing summary. First page is air system sizing summary. Second one is zone sizing summary. You can see in the zone 1, this maximum cooling sensible in 39.1 MBH, airflow is 2019. And then in this zone 1, space load airflow. How many spaces there in zone 1? Dining, kitchen, living room 1, living room 2. So each space, this cooling load and airflow, everything is given here. Then next page, ventilation sizing summary. You can see here the ventilation sizing method is SRA 62.1 2010. We have selected, and design condition is cooling operation, occupant diversity is 100%, and you can see here the space ventilation analysis table. So zone 1, this dining area, the supply air CFM, floor area, then area of air raid, the number of people. So this is the ventilation requirement. The total ventilation requirement is, say, breathing zone outdoor air CFM 233, if you can see here, the design air hole, this outer ventilation air gate at 261. Minimum 233 is required. Go to this next page, you can see here the air system design load summary. So design cooling, so the zone load, so window skylight, solar load, detail, wall transmission, roof transmission, window, floor, everything is given here. Safety factor 10 to 5%, and ventilation load is 261 CFM. It means it's outdoor air. And then the last page is psychometric analysis for package. See, you can see here Dubai, location is Dubai, UAE, altitude is 16 feet, and date for the June cooling day 15:03 o'clock. The first point is outdoor air, so you can see here the first point is here, outdoor air is 107 degree Fahrenheit. Second is mixed air, and third point is central cooling coil outlet, and fourth is central heating coil outlet. Five is nothing but the supply outlet, the supply air. Six is duct heat gain, and seven is room temperature, and eight is return air temperature. So you can see how we are calculating this heating and cooling load calculation using this HAB software in the actual practice. Hourly analysis program for any project, you should follow this step only. So I hope you guys learn from this video how to calculate this heating and cooling load calculation by using HAB. So please like my video and share my video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get the notification of my upcoming video. So thank you for watching my video. Thank you. Bye bye.